My name's Axel Blake and I'm from West London.
So Axel, what made you sign up for BGT this year?
Well, I've got a 12-year-old son, he's in the audience.
Nice.
Yeah. So I just wanted him to believe in yourself, you know? Put your mind to it and you can make it happen.
And do you have a day job?
Yes, I do property maintenance. If you need a kitchen done, Simon, let me know.
I do, actually, Axel.
Give me a call.
I will.
Good.
I want a good rate.
No.
Come, we're friends now.
Yeah, okay, cool. Press that and we're cool, yeah?
I'm really curious with you, because you've got your day job, this is obviously what you want to do. Has there ever been a moment where you've almost lost your confidence and thought, I'm not going to do this?
100%, it's been that time. But when you have family that's looking at you and inspired by you, that's what keeps you going. Yeah. So my son and my daughter, that's the reason. That's the reason.
All right, well, we wish you the best of luck. Go for it.
How are we doing, ladies and gentlemen? Make some noise! I was going to drive here today. I realised I don't have a licence, so... Don't worry, I drove anyways. I took the tube. I've got a love-hate relationship with the tube, you know? I love when it's empty, I hate when it's packed. Can't stand it. Fight people off for the armrest. You ever done that? No, you don't. This old lady's strong. Oh my. Have it, Margaret, have it. Just have it. Some people do their makeup on the tube as well. Make some noise if you've ever done your makeup on the tube. Woo! Legend. A couple weeks ago, I saw a woman, she was doing her whole makeup. A few stops later, she was a whole new person. I was so impressed, I started clapping. I was like, you know what? Yeah, you know. She looked down on me like, I thought, you may be a 9 out of 10 now, but you was a -2 at King's Cross, life. Yeah. Boom. Yeah. I walked off the train like this, in style, yeah. But on a brighter note, just recently my fiance gave birth to a little baby girl. Don't clap, Simon, don't clap. I didn't say the baby's mine, did I? I'm joking, she's mine. Pandemic baby as well, you know? Aww. Yeah, so we wanted to give her a fitting name, so we named her Pfizer, yeah? Yeah. I call her Faisha, yeah? Faisha.
Oh, he's very good.
Technology is moving at such a crazy speed. Evolving crazy. You got the metaverse, you know, you got cryptocurrency. I still get excited about my contactless card when I use it. I do, when I use it. Beep. I love the noise. I've got a jacket with a pocket on his arm. Sometimes I'll leave my card in the arm and I'll pay with my arm. Just to confuse the cashier. That'll be £19.30. Boop. Next week I'm going back, I'm gonna leave my card in my back pocket. I'll be £22.60. Boop. Yeah. Yeah. Then I walk off in style. Yeah. Who's in a happy relationship? Make some noise. Yeah, me and my fiancé have been together for years. And my friends ask me, how do you do it? How are you together for so long? Through the pandemic, baby. And I just say, find your woman that, you know, loves you, understands your flaws, and find your woman that has a good sense of humour. Just make sure those three women don't find out about each other. That's the trick. Yeah, but we don't really have issues. In fact, I'm like, the biggest issue we have is I hate when she would imitate my voice in an argument and it sounds nothing like my voice. I can't stand it. She'd come up to me, I asked you what time you're coming home and you said to me, I don't know what time you're coming home. I don't sound like that. Yes, you do. What I do now, I've got a way to get her back. I imitate her voice back and guess what? She don't like it. I did tell you what time I was coming home and you said, well, make sure you come back at this time. I don't sound like that. Yes, you do. She gets angry. Get out of my face. I say, all right, I'll get out of your face. But how do I do it? In style.
Yay. In style.
My name's Axel Blake. Thank you.
David, what did you think?
A comedy superstar is born tonight on that show. So funny. You made it all seem so effortless. You've got a wonderful, so likeable personality. And everything you said was brilliantly funny and original. I loved it, Axel.
Thank you.
Well done, Axel. Super, super, super confident. The first person, honestly, who's ever made a joke about COVID and was funny. I know it's a bit of a cliche, but, you know, after what everybody's gone through over the last couple of years, boy, A, we needed this show back on air. We needed acts like you. There's one thing I have to tell you, though. I kind of like a granite top. I like a waste disposal unit. I want 25% off, and you get this.
Great night it's been so far. Thank you, Simon Cowell, for giving me the golden buzz as well. I will do your kitchen, don't worry. Just a bit busy right now performing. It's been very interesting getting the golden buzz. Our family treating me different now. Yeah, I come in the house, I get, well, you think you're bad, yeah. Well, you think you're bad, well, because you got the golden buzz around that, yeah. I said, Mum, don't talk to me like that, innit? Don't. And get out, I'm on the toilet. Oh, my God. No privacy. Bombarded with phone calls. The day the episode aired, bombarded with phone calls. Calls from here, there, everywhere. My grandma called. To be honest, I didn't even know my grandma was still alive. I had no idea. I got so many calls that day, I pretended that people called the wrong number. Any call that came in, I was like, hello, Nando's, can I please take your order? All now, my grandma's waiting on a half chicken and chips. And I'm all right with that, really. It's been very interesting. Fiance, she's rooting for me. Not that she supports me, she just wants a bigger wedding, yeah? She just wants a bigger wedding. She said to me, if you win, we win. I was like, okay, all right. Okay, all right. You might want to get that checked out as well, because... No one tells you when you move in together, things change for the worse. Things that was once yours is now hers and yours. Small things like your soul, you know? It's not in the tenancy agreement, is it? No one tells you when you move in together, you're obligated to listen to your wife's work gossip. Day in and day out. And there's nothing you can do about it. Isn't it? There's nothing you can do about it. You just gotta pretend that you're listening. Mm-hmm. Yeah? Really? No. I told you about her. I listen to my partner's work gossip so much, I actually enjoy it now. I actually, right now, it's getting so good. I'm on season 2 right now. It is so. I'm telling you, I think it's Karen that's been eating the food out of the work fridge, yeah? No spoilers. I'm just saying. No one tells you that what can start as a conversation can end as an argument. Because my partner, when she's ready, she could send a message so quickly. She's like a thumb ninja. She just... so quickly. My message, she'll send me a message back. As I'm trying to reply to that message, 8 other messages will come through. By the time I get to the 8th message, she's blocked me and moved on. Yeah, she lives in Scunthorpe now, yeah. Blocked me. Yeah, it's crazy. All the long messages. Guys, you ever received the long messages? Yeah, yeah. Look at me, guys. Don't look at her. Blink once for yes, twice for no. The long, you know the long messages, and you're scrolling, it look like terms and conditions, doesn't it? The more you scroll, the more it goes on. Have you noticed? Oh, oh. You get to the bottom, what's it say? Read more. You're like, oh. More. More. Read more. Block capital letters as well. No punctuation, they're angry. You can tell they're angry from the first sentence, isn't it? Listen, at the end of the day, yeah, you're like, oh, it's 9 in the morning. I tell you, I remember the first time my fiance sent me that long message. I remember it like it was yesterday. Because it was yesterday. Long message. And I know she wanted me to reply back. So I started typing so she could see at the top, I'm typing. It didn't matter what I was typing. I just wanted her to know I'm typing. Because I know she's on the other side, like, Let's see what he's got to say. Get into it, typing away, typing away. Sometimes I pause, then carry on typing. You know what I've done? I cleared the message and I just sent, okay. Wear capes, mate, and all heroes wear capes. And she called me instantly. Because if I'm gonna die, I'm gonna die a legend, yeah? I'm going out in style, yeah? Yeah. I'm telling you, she called me instantly, and I picked up, cleared my throat, and you know what I said? Hello, Nando's, can I please take your order?
I've got to be honest, I was really nervous because, you know, I knew how good your first audition was and I really like you, and I didn't realise actually how brilliant you are. Honestly. I mean, really, I'm not just saying this. And I know people on these shows, you know, we get carried away in the moment. Oh, you're a star, you're a star, you're a star. Well, I'm going to say it because I mean it. You're a star. For you, because, you know, we did meet backstage, and, you know, I saw, you know, who you are as a, you know, person in real life. You know, you're a little softy, and, you know, you love your son and your partner, and I know how important this is to you. So please pick up the phone, and please, please, God, you're in the final.
Yeah, I mean, it was just the Axel Blake show. It wasn't Britain's Got Talent anymore, because you were just so at home on that stage, and you're so, obviously so funny, but you're so likeable too. And so I could listen to you all night.
Brilliantly, brilliantly put together, supernatural, cool, calm and collected. You couldn't have played that any better. You had a great night tonight, Axel, and I think the audience are going to get behind you. It was wonderful. Well done.
And you walked out, you owned the next 5-10 minutes. Every single joke landed, and it was a beautiful circle back round to Nando. So well done.
Thank you very much. Axel, you've got to be pleased with that.
make some noise. Always got to check upstairs. It's been crazy. What an intense week it's been, isn't it? I've got nosy neighbours now. Yeah, I've got them, yeah. Can't turn back now. Real nosy as well. Ian, number 72, yeah. Big guy, always takes the bins out first, yeah. He didn't want to know me before. He wants to know me now. He said to me, "You look more familiar. Have I seen you somewhere recently?" I said, "Yeah, prison, D-Wing." We met in the showers. You think that'll get rid of him, isn't it? No, Ian's still nosy. And he knows everybody's business in the area. He said to me, "Don't trust the kids at number 64. I said, "Why?" He said, "The other day, they stole my lucky Jubilee pants off the washing line." I said, "What do you want me to do with that information, Ian? And how do you even know it's them? It could have been the foxes." This is when I knew Ian was one of a kind. He said, "I know all the foxes in the area." And they would never do that to me. All right, Dr. Doolittle. And I just want to say thank you for everyone that voted for me on the semi-finals. Thank you, everyone. Yeah, thank you. Thank you. It's so emotional. But it's now shown me how the nation views me as well. Taking pictures with some fans outside. Yeah, I was. And I heard one of the mums say, "Stormzy's put on a bit of weight, hasn't he?" Stormzy! I know nothing like Stormzy. Anthony Joshua, yeah, but Stormzy. I said, "That's it, I'm going gym today." Because I used to go gym religiously, you know, and I mean religiously. Christmas, Easter, Ramadan. Yeah. I'm not gonna lie. I did. I was one of those guys in front of the mirror as well. You know, I wasn't even holding weights. I was just, I wasn't even at the gym. I was at the bus stop. Like a weirdo. To lose weight, I used to cycle to work with my mate. Never again, by the way, never again. The reason is because there's different type of cyclists, isn't it? You've got cyclists and you've got cyclists. My mate is a what? Cyclist. They're different. He's got the spike shoes, looking like he's doing track and fields. The spandex suit, looking like Spider-Man from Scotland. He's got the bike with the curved handlebars. Yeah, you've seen them. How do they ride? Meanwhile, I'm on a Boris bike in my work shoes, trying to keep up with Mr. Tour de France. Right past me, "You need a hand, mate." "No, Toby, I need a car." Speaking of cars, now I know what it feels like to be cut off by a driver. Yeah, because we all know, I've been on both sides now, and we all know cyclists hate when you cut them off. They always got something to say as they go past, isn't it?
"Why don't you get out of it?"
It's true. It is so true. So I said, forget all the cycling. That's not for me. It's not for me. I stick to dance. I love a bit of dance. Yeah. Yeah, that's right. Calm down, David. Stop flirting. I'm taking. Anything as well, anything. I don't care what it, when my doorbell goes off, I'm like, boom, boom, boom. Boom, boom, boom. Yeah. Open the door, naked to my nosy neighbors, boom, boom, boom. Yeah, by the way, Ian, boom, boom, boom. That's my time, man, that's your blade. Thank you.
Well, Simon, we've got
I mean, what can I say? I mean, hello.
Brilliant.
I feel really emotional for you right now, because when we first met, we talked about, you know, what your day job was and what your dream was, you know? And you told me this was your dream. And then you talked about being a dad, and, you know, I saw your son in the VT again there, and your bond. It's not just how brilliant you are, it's how much I like you and how much we all like you as well. And honestly, I really do believe this. I really, really believe we have discovered a star.
Yes.
And I could not be happier.
Yeah, and, you know, that was a winning performance in every way, completely faultless. I would love to see you walk away with the trophy tonight. I mean, and you would storm at the Royal Variety. You're a superstar, mate. Well done.
Do you know the thing I love the most? You just take time with it, you let it marinate, you casually drop them bombs, and you do it in style. Yeah! Yes! Loved it!
I mean, you're just a gorgeous person as well. I think that's what it is. I feel like I want to take you off and then go and have a drink with you out there. And I know we'd get on.
Don't.
And the whole cyclist thing, I am so with you. Why do they wear the cameras? They're asking for trouble already. What is it about? I loved your whole act tonight.
Thank
it was
you,
a winning act.
Amazing.
Best
judges.
Amazing.
Well done.
But no, stay here. So, we're left with Jamie Leahy and Chuck Axelblake and Tom Ball. The public chose you as this year's final three, but only one of you can leave here tonight as this year's winner. The third place act in Britain's Got Talent 2022, third place is...
Oh, we've loved you. You were brilliant tonight.
You've been brilliant. What next? What, first of all, back to school?
Back to school Tuesday. Can't wait.
Listen, well done. Congratulations. Third place. We have loved having you. Let's hear it one more time for this year's third place act, Mr. Tom Ball, everybody.
And we're left with two. Okay. After an incredible set of auditions, five amazing semi-finals, and an unforgettable final, it all comes down to this.
Just two acts remain. Jamie Leahy and Chuck and Axel Blake. One of you is about to leave here with £250,000 and a spot on the bill at the Royal Variety Performance.
Here we go then. The winner of Britain's Got Talent 2022 is... Axel Blair! Congratulations, but a massive commiserations to Jamie Leahy. You've been, Jamie, to come second in this year's final says a lot, pal. You're brilliant. You must be thrilled.
I am, yeah, it's amazing. Thanks.
What would you like to say to everybody out there who voted for you?
I'd like to say thanks for all the support and, yeah. And there's one guy. His name is Lewis Devine, and he has helped me so much.
Oh, come here, you. Come here. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up one more time for a very deserving runner-up, Jamie Lee and Chuck.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner. How do you feel?
Words can't even explain. I am shaking. Thank you, everyone, for voting for me. It means the world to me. Thank you, everyone at home. I can't even, there's not even words to explain right now. I can't believe it.
Do you know, I'm thrilled that you won, but what's going to get on my goat is the fact you were Simon Cowell's golden buzzer at. Damn it! He's going to be thrilled. Well done, pal. Well done.
I don't know what to say. Apart from thank you and in style, yeah!